good afternoon, guys. As you can see, I have taken the screen extender off. Tell you why. Before we went to Whanganui and I tested it, it felt quite good. However, with a passenger on, a pillion passenger on the bike, I think it must have changed the dynamic, because going up to Whanganui it wasn't so great. So I changed the angle of that extender, windscreen extender, a little bit, and it improved it. But I think there was a lot of weight on the screen and it was really wobbling around quite badly. Anyway, I've taken it off now and go along the motorway in a minute and test it out. It's the 31st today, so if I manage to get this video posted, I wish you guys a great New Year's Eve and a great New Year, of course, because we all want to have a good one and ride our bike safely, or do whatever we do safely. Try not to catch any bloody stuff that's going around, flus and COVIDs and every other thing. Where am I right now? I think we've got... So I'm going the back roads over the hill here, and eventually that would bring us down onto the motorway. So you can't, I can't really tell how good the screen is at this speed. We're only doing 50 kilometres an hour. I like the look of it better without that extender on there. It looks quite cool. Yes, yeah, so I adjusted it when we got to Whanganui on the way home. It was better, but still not as good. Not as good as when I first tried it by myself. I mean, they are naked bikes, aren't they? You know, naked as a G-bird, boy. They're naked, and maybe they're supposed to be ridden that way. Go along the motorway shortly and assess what it's like, and then I'll say, well, yay or nay, whether it's going to stay on or just go back to the basic bike. Over the Big Dipper. bad view. Probably not too good on the old GoPro, eh? Yeah, so everyone, wish everyone a great new year. I think it was 76, the old Mark 3 Zephyr going to work. This road here was blocked, and so I decided we'll go the other way. And then a big slip came down right beside us in the car, so I just turned around and went back home again. Thank goodness I did, because I would never go home for about 3 days. They were massive floods then, my goodness. I think it's good for the dog's eyes. Probably dries them out. this old bike here. Great big tank it is. No paper left. Great. So 167 divided by 10 is 16.7 kilometers per liter. Yeah, that's not very good, is it? Stupid number plate. That electric car had no oil for a number plate. Without oil, it wouldn't be driving around. All the bodywork, tyres, paint, all made with oil. Brake fluid, steering fluid, oil. Should be, I suppose empty head must have gone, so they've just got no oil. According to the display up there, it's 20 degrees. 20 degrees! Good, that's okay. Right, I'll just park here for a minute. Yeah, no, 16.7 or something, 16 point something kilometres per litre isn't very good, is it? And the Triumph was getting 20 when I was testing the fuel consumption, so mind you, that's a bit more modern, that engine. This is early fuel injection as opposed to late model fuel injection. And I do tend to twist the throttle on this a bit more because it's so good. Need new batteries. So there it is. Right. Quite like it. What's it like from the side? Very nice, eh? Might be a keeper. So Mr. TPR, Tim, I'm just showing you what the settings are. On the GoPro 10, I had it on 1080p, 60 frames a second, linear. I've just changed it to wide now. And on the GoPro 8, I had it on 1080p, 60 frames a second wide. So I don't know if it, because YouTube only does it up to 1080p when they put it on online. So whether having it in 4K or 2K is worth the effort, I don't know. 2K's are probably okay, but 4K, I've found a lot of time spent bloody downloading it and rendering it, and it just took forever. Anyway, thanks for watching, everyone, and have a good new year.